the ways of ants, concerning the ways of ants. We took our text from Proverbs chapter 6. Proverbs chapter 6 from verse 6. Go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider our ways and be wise, which having no captain, overseer, or ruler, provides our supplies in the summer and gathers our food in the harvest. No controller, no president, no governor, but they were able to organize themselves. Proverbs 30, verse 24 to 25. There are four things which are little on the earth, for they are exceedingly wise. The ants are a people not strong, yet they prepare their food in the summer. They prepare their food in the summer. Ants, they are very industrious, very organized, well organized. They are very, very persistent in doing anything. Very resilient, they are very resilient. They work very hard, they are very patient, they are cooperative. You know, there is so much of social order in the colony. All ants honor and respect each other and work in partnership toward their common goal. They work in partnership, they partner together towards that common goal. Worker ants are great architects. Working in partnership and cooperation with each other and can show us how to construct our dreams into reality. They can help us to see how we can bring all our desires to reality. Worker ants, they design their houses and they build the colony as great architecture. They are also very persistent, and as they touch anything to do, they do all these things with all their heart. The special quality that God gave to this being is something that we should consider, we should look at. You could ask me, why all this? Why are we studying ants? Why should we be studying this? First and foremost, the Bible told us to consider their ways. And anything the Bible asks us to do, as Christians, we need to do it. And that's why we are studying this. Also, to have an happy and peaceful ending without any end of life regrets, without regretting in life at the end. We must think on these things we are talking about, these qualities of life that ants always have, and see how we can apply this into our lives. We need to gather all these informations. It's not sufficient, of course, to gather all these informations, but it's also very important to apply this information to our life. So let us cultivate the habit of partnership. We're going to look into partnership today. Last week, in part 5, we perused the cooperation, the sense of cooperation of ants, how they cooperate together to do whatever they need to do. In the past, we have seen how ants are very resilient. We have seen how ants are very persistent in anything that they do. We have seen how ants are very patient when they desire to do anything. So today we want to see partnership, that quality that God gave to them. I think it is very important that we should cultivate the habit of partnership in life. Very important. With your husband, partner with him. With your wife, partner. Children, partner with your parents. In the office, partner with your workers. When we come together, we can do more when we are together. When we partner together, we can do more. And you know, cooperation and partnership, they're very close. If I don't cooperate with you, it's going to be very hard for me to partner with you. So in your house, in the church, at office, let us partner together. At the end of life, when we are studying, this is very important. At the end of life, we can look back and be happy that we're able to achieve so many things in life. We can look back and thank God for the life He has given us. Ants, I told you, their brain cells. Their brain cells are about 250,000. And human brain cell is 10,000 million. We have 10,000, each brain cell of human is 10,000 million cells. Each brain, 10,000 million cells. So if An ordinary animal with 250,000 brain cells can perform so much, and their lifespan between 45 days to 60 days. Within that short lifespan, they can work so hard and be able to achieve, and then the Bible or Solomon can tell us to go and consider their ways. Then how much more human beings? How much more human beings? Some can live over 100 years now. Some can live more than that even now. I mean, people live long now. If an ordinary animal who will just live for 45 to 60 days can do so much, don't you think we can do better? With the number of brain cells that we have, don't you think we can do better? So that's why we are studying this. So at the end of life, what matters most is how well you finish your race. That is what matters most. And that's why we are having this information. It's never too late for us to consider what we have done in the past, and then be able to make corrections, so that at the end of our days, at the end of our life, we can be so much happy, we can depart with peace, that we have given life our best. Amen. Tell somebody, give life your best.
Give life your best.
Give life your best. I pray that the Almighty God will help us, all of us, to finish well and finish strong at the end of our life.
Amen.
That's my prayer. That's my desire. That as many people that I may have contact with, that many people that may listen to me, they may consider their ways and give life the best. Maximize every potential. Walk through every open door. Put in your best and achieve so much, so that at the end of life, there will be no regrets. Make decision and commitment now to be the best you can ever be. Then you can do it, you can make commitments that you want to be the best you can ever be for your children. You want to be the best that you can ever be with your partner. That you want to partner with your children or with your husband or your wife, even in your office, so you can cooperate and make sure that all that you are doing can bring positive impact in our generation. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Be the best you can have, you can ever be. You know, God has created us so much with so many opportunities, and it's left for us to be able to use this opportunity. Listen to me very carefully. My desire in life, even as I go through all these messages, as we see the life of all these creatures that God created with all the special endowment. In fact, we are more endowed than anything God created. We are more endowed. So it's my desire. So like Paul said in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7 to 8, I want my life at the end, when I will be leaving this place, by the grace of God, I want to be able to say, I have fought the good fight. I want to be able to say that I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I want to finish this race. My destiny, I want to fulfill. My purpose, I want to fulfill. I want to be able to say that. I have kept the faith. I want to be able to say that even at the end of everything, I'm still standing as a Christian. That I will depart to be with my Lord. That's my desire. That absent in this body, I will be present with the Lord. And no one can shake that desire from me. I have determined to do that. Let us forget about all these trivial things, these mundane things. Some of us, we spend precious time on little things. Things that you're supposed to let go. Instead for us to cooperate with God that created us and partner with God to fulfill His purpose in our lives, so we spend so much time, you know, backbiting, quarreling, fighting this, fighting that, complaining. All these trivial things, they will not count at the end of the day. At the end of the day, what is going to count is you will be able to tell God, give good account of yourself, that the life that God has given you has not been wasted. That's what we count at the end of the day. I mean, you have to stand and give account of yourself. You cannot give any excuse. You cannot say, my pastor caused this, or my husband caused this, my wife caused this, or this and that. You cannot say that. You will stand before God, you will give account of yourself. The Bible tells me it has been appointed unto man once to die. After that is what?
Judgment.
Judgment. And that has to do with you giving account of yourself. So let us think about this, my peace. Let us consider the nature of Christ. Everything that God has given you, all the opportunity, make the best of everything. Amen. Give life your best. If you have a gift in the church, get involved. Use Every time counts. The one you have spent yesterday is gone, it's not going to come back. Every time counts. Put in your best. Put in your best for your family. Put in your best, you know, for your church. Put in your best in your place of work. Be the most valuable person anywhere you will find yourself. That they will remember you for good. Praise the Lord. They will remember you for good. It's so important, it's so essential that we live this kind of positive life. It's so important. It's essential that we do this. And I tell you the truth, God is a rewarder. He will reward you.
Amen.
Absence of belonging. Anywhere you may be, absence of belonging. In your family, there are people that live in a family as if they don't belong to that family. They don't take care of things. They allow things to waste away. They think everything is free because they don't have sense of belonging. Some people, even in the church, they don't have sense of belonging. They think everything here, oh, this person is going to do it, that person is going to do it, and eventually nobody is going to do it. In the place of work, some people, they use the things they have in the place of work as if, I don't care. But if you carry that kind of attitude to the place of work, it will affect everything in you. Have the sense of partnership. Have the sense of belonging. Let somebody see Christ in your life. Let the difference be very clear, and the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So we have looked into persistence, resilience, patience, and cooperation. So today, let's see partnership. You know, in those definitions we gave last week, I said, cooperation is the process of working together to the same end. Working together to the same end, for the same purpose. That is what we call cooperation. You work with somebody, you work together to achieve the same vision. But look at partnership. Dictionary. In dictionary, partnership is defined as an association of two or more people as partners. So if you don't cooperate with somebody, can you partner with that person?
No.
So these things are connected. If you are not patient, you are not partner. If you cannot work with people, if you are not persistent, so that you are patient to make sure that the task is well done, you cannot partner. So these things are connected. But today, let's look at partner. As you can see, if you are not cooperating, you cannot be in partnership with anyone or for anything. So you have to cooperate with God to be in partnership or to be in association with His promises, blessings, and covenants. If you want to enjoy God's promises, if you want to enjoy God's covenant promises, all His blessings for you, you need to partner with God. Amen?
Amen.
You need to cooperate with God. If God says, this is how you have to do things. See, we have the known will of God. The known will of God and all that God wrote down in the Bible for us. The revelation knowledge in the scriptures. So God gave us all the guidelines on how we have to live our lives. So now, if we partner with God, it means we will cooperate with God, it means we will do it according to His ideal will. According to His will, we will do things. Then if we can do that, it's going to be very easy for us to now cooperate with God and partner with Him on the unknown will of God. Unknown will of God. If you can fulfill the known will of God, if you can cooperate with God for His known will, things that are written in the Bible, do you think you'll be able to cooperate with Him on the unknown? No. On the unknown, I have seen people, they want to know every step they take in life. They want somebody to tell them, go to New York. Hey, don't go. Go to Washington. Hey, don't go. Go to Atlanta. Hey, don't go. They want somebody to do that for them. Whereas, God that lives in us has given us every opportunity to know all these things. The one thing is to know, another thing is to do it. And another thing is to do it right. So if you don't partner with God, no matter what somebody is telling you, if you don't cooperate with God, no matter what somebody is telling you, you won't receive faith. The bottom line is to have the desire, to have the purpose in your heart, that come what may, you will live in God's purpose for your life. Even as you face stormy life, as you face challenges, you continue to press forward. You continue to press forward. Continue to partner with God. Continue to cooperate with God so that all the process He had prepared for you will be totally completed and His covenant blessings begin to reign in your life. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, as partners in progress, there is solidarity. These people, they have what we call solidarity. They watch everybody's back. In the kingdom of ants, they protect everyone. They walk hand in hand. They are always together. There is solidarity. They all live together in the colony. You hardly see an ant all alone. According to the scientist's study, you hardly see them all alone. Let's see 1 Corinthians 3:9. For we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field. You are God's building. We belong to God. So, we should be able to, as brethren, help each other, work together, watch each other's back, advise each other rightly, not taking advantage of anyone. There's what they call continuity in their partnership. They continue together and work continuously. They work together all the time. Look at Galatians 6 verse 9. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. So they form that kind of partnership to help each other, to provide for each other, to eat together, to watch each other's back. We're in a generation where people are so selfish, people are so self-centered, even Christians. It touched my heart when a Christian will go to another Christian for help, and that Christian will take advantage of that one. Oh yeah, he doesn't know, he doesn't know anything. Slap him, before he understands the environment. It's touched, you know, let me be very honest with you. It's unchristian. When a Christian brother or a Christian sister, when he or she comes to you for help, you as a Christian, you must look at that person as you are looking at Christ, as looking at God in that person, and give it your best. You love that person like you can love yourself. That is your neighbor. That person right there coming to you for his use is who?
Your neighbor.
And then you're going to give account of what you deal, how you deal with that person. You give account of it. You look at what the scripture says. So let us, that Galatians 6 says, let us not grow weary while doing good. For in due season we shall eat if we do not lose heart. Check again. 1 Corinthians 10:31. 1 Corinthians 10:31 says, therefore, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do all for the glory of God. Amen. Do everything that you do for the glory of God. If someone comes to you for any help and you do that, do it to whose glory? To the glory of God. That person may not pay you back. That person may walk away from you. But I tell you the truth, God sees everything, and God who sees in secret will do what? We reward you. That person may not even reward you. In fact, if you want to reward me, you won't be able to measure the kind of reward you're supposed to give me. God will measure the best reward for me. I prefer to fall into the hands of God. Because God is kind, God is just, God is good, God is stable, God is solid, God is dependable. If I fall into the hands of anyone who could have opportunity to do something, it may change his mind. Anybody can do anything, but when God is to do things, God is very conscious. God is so great. God is so merciful. God is so gracious. The ants work in production. They spend their time productively. Every second God has given us, we must spend this second productively. It's very important. If you have 24 hours in a day, you should be able to give account of how you have spent these hours in a day. In your office, you must be able to spend the hours that are supposed to work for the employer productively. Every employer is seeking an employee who can productively spend time. Amen?
Amen.
Any employee who cannot spend time productively, if he or she is exposed, may be fired. So the same thing, God wants us to spend our time productively. James 2, from verse 17 to 18, James chapter 2, it does also faith by itself. If it does not have works, it's dead. But someone will say, you have faith and have works, Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. So, we cannot just tell you I'm a Christian, I have faith, and then you do not do any work, you waste time, you're not productive. God does not want that. I'm expecting every one of us in this church to participate in one thing or the other. God requires from you to do what?
Participate
in one way or the other. Any way you can do it. It can be open participation, it can be secret participation. We have to work together. Look at it, the kingdom of these little animals, hands. They work together, nobody is supervising anybody. Everyone knows what to do. And they do everything for the progress of the kingdom, for the progress of the colony, for the enjoyment of everyone. So we should do the same thing. That's why this message is coming to us at this point in time. Let's work together. Let's mind everyone's business. Let's help each other to achieve great. When we are together, we achieve what?
Great.
One way the enemy can eat us hard is to divide us. That's the way. That's one of the tools of the enemies. If anything is going to come in between you and your husband or your family, the first thing is going to bring is division. When you are divided, it's going to be very hard to achieve anything. When we are divided, together we stand, divided we do what? That marriage is falling. If the faith would quickly come together and unite, I'm telling you, the story is not going to be a good story. Also in an association, also in a country, also in a church. So we have to come together. And Jesus said, I will build my church, and the gate of hell will not prevail against it. One of the gates of hell of prevailing, or one of the gates of hell that the devil can use, is division. You must work hand in hand to ensure that the gate of hell will not prevail in your family.
Amen.
You must work with your husband, your wife, your children, and ensure that the gate of hell will not prevail right there.
Amen.
So that what we are building will stand.
Amen.
For the glory of God.
Amen.
James 4:17, therefore, to him who knows to do good and does not do it, to him it is sin. All this thing I'm telling you, they are written in the scriptures. Now you know. Can't tell me you don't know. Apply these things into your life. Amen?
Amen.
Let us be very productive. Let us partner together. Let us be partners in progress. Don't partner with Satan. Partner with God. Partner for good things. Let's cooperate together. As church, let us work hand in hand together. If anyone offends any other person, forgive and let go. If you are going to say anything about me at my back, maybe say something good. Partner with me, say something good. If I come to you, say something encouraging. That's how you partner with me. Do not discourage me. As a matter of fact, I do not like to hang around people that discourage people. Don't discourage me. Nothing in this life comes cheap. Anything that will be good, we need certain investment. Either investment of time, investment of energy, that will be strong. I mean, patience has to be invested. So don't come and tell me, don't come and create fear in me and tell me, oh, hey, that place you are, it's not easy. And begin to give me mountains of problems. But my God is bigger than any mountain.
Amen.
The God that I serve is bigger than any storm.
Absolutely.
So we should be able to ride over any storm, over any obstacle. Nothing should be able to stand before our success, before our breakthrough. Nothing. If you can depend on God, your partner with God, nothing will be able to stand against us. I can tell you right now, as we are sitting down here, if somebody is telling the statement of discouragement to you, or tell you words of discouragement, tell that person that the God that you are serving is a God of encouragement.
Oh, yes.
He's a God that will support you. He's a God that will not leave you alone. Even at the darkest time of life, the Lord will still be with you.
Yes.
He said, I will be with you until the end of time. He told the disciples, in the world will see tribulation, but be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. God looks to, he looks into every detail of our lives. And God is guiding us, is protecting us. Look at the testimony of this brother this morning. Look at his testimony. He ran for God. What would, see, I was telling that brother, in my life, I have seen so many things. At least I can remember four times on gunpoint. Gunpoint, four times in my life, I've been attacked four times on gunpoint. And I'm standing here. I'm not going to tell you about accident that I've been involved in. I was driving a car and the brake failed. The brake did what?
Failed.
The brake on a slope failed. The passenger I had beside me was shaking. My effort then was not to kill people. Because people were selling, you know how they do it back home? People were selling on the street. This one selling on the street. And the brake failed. The whole woman was shaking like this. Was taken like this, and I didn't want to kill anybody. I did not want any life to draw from my hand, either by accident, either by calculation, either by anything. I do not want to have that. I don't want to go and be telling God, forgive me, I kill somebody. I do not want it. But by the grace of God, that car stopped with the help of an obstacle. Even though the car was almost gone, but no life was lost. When there is life, there is hope. Property can go as long as life can be saved. It's finished. The friend will say, self in it. It's finished. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let us partner with God. He will see us through. Let us be encouraged. Let us partner with each other. Look at that kingdom. They work together. They provide for each kingdom. Nobody is providing anybody. Everybody is doing his own work for the progress of the colony. Everything you lay your hands upon, do it for the progress of the kingdom. Do it for the progress, either in the church, do it for the progress of the church. Either in your family, do it for the progress of your family. Children, anywhere you are, in your home, do as if you are the one paying the bills. Amen?
Amen.
Do as what?
Like
the one paying the bills. Don't let your parents tell you, put on that light. Put on that television. Don't wear that water. Don't do this. Behave as if, oh, I'm the one doing what?
Paying
the bills. Mommy and daddy, the way you do it in the family, do it as if you are doing it unto who? Unto the Lord. In your office, let's do the same thing. As if we are working for God. Do it like that. Maintain good integrity. Be the best ever you can be. Be the most valuable person anywhere you find yourself. And I tell you, God who sees in the secret, we reward you in the open. Let me close by giving you this little story. Many may not see what to do, but God does. The story is told of a craftsman who had traveled to America from Europe to dedicate his life to some of the detailed work in one of this country's grandest places of worship. I'm reading it verbatim. One day, a sightseer was touring the edifice, was going around looking at the edifice, and observed the workman meticulously laboring near the high ceiling on a symbol which could hardly be seen from the floor. This man was meticulously making it perfect to give it a professional touch. To give it an excellent thought, and I think every one of us, we should do our things excellently. That you do it to be the best that can stand any test, that can stand and win any competition. This man was doing that. What is more, he seems to be occupied with a detail on the top. Even out of view of the most carefully observant worshiper, somebody you cannot even see, even people that can really observe, can see. Any of those errors, if there's any error on that ceiling. So, the sightseer said, why are you being so exact? No one can even see the detail you care creating from this distance. Why are you so, nobody can see that? The busy artist replied, not missing a stroke, God can. That is, God can see it. Sometimes we hide, some of us, we think, oh, nobody's seeing us. We hide to do our own thing. Anything that we are doing, you have to look here, you have to look there, you have to close the door, you have to hide somewhere. Don't think that, even if no one is seeing you, God does what? God sees you. And God who sees in the secret will definitely reward us in the open. So, whatever we do, let us partner with God positively. Partner with whoever is around you, that's your neighbor. Partner together. And as we do that, the Lord sees our efforts. We definitely reward us. And when we finish this race in this life, we can boldly say we have finished our course. We can boldly say that we have finished the race. We can boldly say that we have kept the faith. We can boldly, with joy, without any end of life regret, depart this place. May that be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At the end of your day, when you are departing this place, may you depart in peace in Jesus' name.
Amen.
With every bold, with every, peace of heart, may you not regret on any issue in your life as you depart in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, precious Father. Father, we bless you this afternoon. We worship you for your mercy. We thank you for the opportunity to come together as your children. As you have spoken to us, help us, O Father, to apply your words into our lives. Keep us, O Father, from every effort of the enemy to delay your word from our heart. Daddy, as you said, we should consider hands. We should consider their ways. Help us, O Father, to take this seriously. And with great consideration, desire for all these qualities and apply them into our lives. So that at the end, we take glory in all that we do. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.